But at some point afterwards, I'd also like to get a team to talk a little bit about the whole issue of anti-vaxxers, because we've been talking a lot about why we need vaccines and the importance and whatnot. But I think there's also a lot of misinformation out there that we need to address. Having said that, I'd like to invite Nadia to ask her question.
Thank you for allowing me to ask. So actually, along the veins about anti-vaxxers, I think one of the things that could incentivize people to take up the vaccines is by telling them, what they would gain from actually being vaccinated. So how will the policies actually change as more and more people in Malaysia get vaccinated? Will there be a clear framework communicated? So for example, once we hit 50% of the population vaccinated, maybe masks are only required on public transport. And if we hit 80%, perhaps we don't need quarantine anymore. Will there be a framework and will this be communicated to the public?
As far as a framework of an exit policy is concerned, yes, we will want to communicate certain privileges or certain normalcy that can be restored once there's adequate or good coverage of the vaccination. However, this must be based on science. So the expert working group will continue to monitor what's happening in other countries. To see whether or not we can dispense with non-pharmaceutical interventions like wearing of masks, like physical distancing, etc. But I think it has to be done on an equitable basis. There is talk now about, and I read an article in the New York Times just before coming on to Clubhouse, that there is a country which is considering privileges given to those who have been vaccinated and denying privileges to those who have not been vaccinated. Now, this raises a big ethical problem because, first of all, there will be those people who cannot be vaccinated because of underlying health conditions, people who are immunocompromised, the jury is still out on pregnant women. You discriminate certain people. If it is done equitably, in a sense that, guys, if we reach 80%, we can start having more privileges, we can start dispense with MCO, PKP. That is something that we are willing to consider. But again, it's early days. We still don't have enough data about whether the vaccines prevent transmission. We know that the vaccines are very effective in preventing the severe symptoms or outcomes of COVID-19. But as far as sterilizing immunity, we're not quite sure yet. So we'll continue to monitor. In fact, I had a conversation with the Singapore Foreign Minister yesterday, and they are still trying to understand how to open travel bubbles with other countries. They're not ready to do so yet because they're still monitoring the data, the effectiveness data from their immunization program.